Joe Employee, the new lead customer admin for Acme North America, is working through his task list in the ServiceNow customer self-service portal. Joe is responsible for managing the upgrades on his company's instances. Joe needs to set up an upgrade to the development instance with the latest patch for Fuji. Before scheduling an upgrade, see the ServiceNow product documentation for best practices for upgrades, including how to plan and prepare. Upgrade processes and plans are reusable for future upgrades. And now back to our scenario. Joe logs into the customer self-service portal on HI. The Manage Upgrades page provides a single location to manage all instance upgrades. For the instance Joe needs to upgrade, we select the version from the Upgrade Available choice list. If a red circle appears next to a release, the option is blocked. Pointing to the icon shows us why it's blocked or requires entitlement approval. In this case, the version requires version entitlement approval. If a yellow warning appears next to a release, there may be some issue with upgrading to that release from the release currently installed on the instance. You can point to the icon to display a brief description, or click it to open a knowledge base article for more information. If Up to Date appears in this column, no upgrades are yet available for that version. In this case, upgrades are available for all of the instances. When we've selected the version, we click Schedule to select the time to start the upgrade. Here, the version we selected requires entitlement approval. A request will be submitted on our company's behalf. All we need to do is indicate when we would like the upgrade to start. We need to allow the specified number of days for the entitlement to be approved before the upgrade can begin. If the version we select does not require an entitlement, we could select Right Now to start the upgrade the next time the upgrade scheduled job runs. Otherwise, we need to click the calendar icon to select when the upgrade should take place. Time is expressed here on a 24-hour clock. Because an entitlement is required in this case, the specified number of days from today is selected by default. We set the upgrade to start 10 to 15 minutes before the upgrade scheduled job runs, which is every 60 minutes, not necessarily at the top of the hour. But what is the upgrade scheduled job? Let's look at how ServiceNow upgrades are initiated. The upgrade and check upgrade script scheduled jobs in the instance's system scheduler execute the upgrade process across all nodes of an instance. When you submit an upgrade request through HI, a new WAR file is associated with the instance record, but nothing happens with it until the upgrade job runs on the instance to check for a new WAR file. If the upgrade job finds a new WAR file associated with an instance, it downloads and unpacks that file, and then restarts the active node. The check upgrade script job runs automatically when a node is restarted. If it finds a new and unpacked WAR file, it processes the file and begins updating the database. Let's see how this works in practice. In this example, our upgrade scheduled job starts at the top of the hour every hour. According to best practices, upgrades should be performed after business hours. We want our upgrade to start at 10 p.m. 5 days from today, so we set the date and time in HI to 9:45 p.m. which is 15 minutes before the upgrade scheduled job. So we'll set the start time to 9:45 p.m., which is 21:45 on this 24-hour clock. Now we'll submit the upgrade request. We can view all of the entitlement requests made by our company from the link on the Manage Upgrades dashboard. Let's take a look at the entitlement request we just submitted. You can communicate with the ServiceNow Entitlement Manager at any time by entering comments in the request form. The Entitlement Manager can respond to your comments as well, and they will appear here for you to view. Back in the Manage Upgrades dashboard, the status field shows us that the approval is pending for our version entitlement request, or displays the date and time for the upgrade that we requested if an approval was not required. Once an entitlement is requested, the entitlement is granted to the company, and the company can apply it to any instance. A change request is created for each instance for which you requested an entitlement. To cancel an upgrade on an instance for which we've requested an entitlement, we need to access the pending version entitlement request. Click on the number link and in the Instance Upgrade Info page, click Cancel Upgrade. We can click Upgrade to reinstate the upgrade up until the entitlement is approved. After that, you can schedule the upgrade directly from the Manage Upgrades dashboard. When the Entitlement Manager approves your version request, the request status changes to approved, a change request is automatically created, and you will receive an email notification. The upgrade for any instances for which you requested an entitlement is automatically kicked off at the date and time you requested. What about the situation when we schedule an upgrade that does not require entitlement approval, but we want to reschedule or cancel the upgrade? In this case, a change request is automatically generated after we schedule the upgrade. We can click to view it or close the window. If we wanted to cancel or reschedule this upgrade, we would modify the change request and cancel the upgrade. Then we could request a new upgrade and specify a new date and time. Now, back in our instance, we set the time to kick off the upgrade in the upgrade scheduled job. By default, only users with the admin role can view and edit scheduled jobs. First, we'll check a few things. The trigger type should be set to interval, and the default repeat interval for this job is every hour, which is fine. System ID should be set to none, so this is correct. And finally, we set the actual start time for the upgrade here, 10 p.m., which is 2200 on a 24-hour clock. When we save this, the next upgrade scheduled job will run at 10 p.m. and every hour on the hour thereafter, unless we change the time again later. Now let's make sure the Check Upgrade Script scheduled job is set up correctly. The trigger type should be set to Run at System Startup, and it is, so we're good to go. System ID here does contain a value, which is fine as is. Our upgrade is set in High to start at 9:45 p.m. In our ServiceNow instance, it's set to start at 10 p.m. This delay is needed to allow the upgrade request to update High before the upgrade scheduled job runs on the instance to kick off the upgrade. Now let's take a look at a common cause of confusion, where an upgrade is thought to have failed when in fact it hasn't yet started because the scheduled start time has not been reached. Let's say the upgrade start time in High and the instance are both set to 10 p.m. At exactly 10 p.m., High starts updating its records, so this task would be complete a little after 10. Meanwhile, in the instance, the upgrade job runs at 10 p.m. to check for a new WAR file, but the file isn't there yet because High hasn't finished its updates. So the upgrade job won't start the upgrade until the next repeat interval, 1 hour later, at 11 p.m., when it finds the new WAR file. Similar upgrade start delays can occur whenever the upgrade start times in High and the instance are not coordinated. So to avoid these delays, set the start time in High 10 to 15 minutes before the upgrade scheduled job run that's closest to the date and time you want your upgrade to take place. Since Joe has scheduled the upgrade and verified that the upgrade scheduled across High and the ServiceNow instance are coordinated, his task list just got shorter. Later, Joe can access the Manage Instances page to verify that the instance was successfully upgraded. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.